Our region is in a period of rising strategic uncertainty. The rules and norms that have provided a foundation for our stability, and hence our prosperity, are under pressure, in particular from authoritarian regimes. The Quad is a grouping with a positive and ambitious agenda. We continue to support the centrality of ASEAN, including to advance practical implementation of ASEAN's outlook on the Indo-Pacific. The Quad has made practical commitments, and we're delivering on them.
The interactions that we've had has made it evident that robust bilateral relations between our respective countries, our strategic convergences, and our shared democratic values have all combined to make the Quad a vibrant and substantial framework.
Back in December, I was in Jakarta, and I set out the United States' vision for a free and open Indo-Pacific, which, more than any other region, will shape the trajectory of the 21st century. We talk about a free and open Indo-Pacific a lot. It's worth spending just a second on what that actually means to us, and it's a shared meaning. It means people will be free in their daily lives and live in open societies. It means the countries will be able to choose their own path and their own partners. It means that goods, ideas, individuals will flow freely in the region, and that problems will be dealt with openly, according to the rules of the road that everyone has agreed to. We believe the only way to make that vision a reality is to deepen our engagement with allies and partners who share it. And that's exactly what the Quad is all about. As Indo-Pacific countries, as democracies, as nations who understand how important it is to uphold the international rules that have provided the foundation for decades of shared security and prosperity, it's in our interest to do more together.